present to you immobilization devices and their uses, and on why we use them for CT dose planning, at the same time using them for treatment. When it comes to radiotherapy and setting up of patients, it is three things. We look at patient comfort, we look at setup reproducibility, and we look at accuracy, that is accuracy of the setup. So if we want to reproduce a setup for a patient, look at the kind of CT we have. This is how it looks from the beginning. So what we actually do is, because the couch is not the couch of the treatment floor, it's not the same as what we have here, we try to shift it. And then we click on what you see here. This way, we can reproduce the procedure we're going to do here. And then, we can reproduce the same thing we do here on the other arm. Then the patients can, then we know that we are not doing anything wrong with the setup. So with this, the reproducibility aspect is sorted. And then patient comfortability, we try to make sure the patient is comfortable in the position we're going to set her up, him or her up. So we use the immobilization devices to help us to be able to achieve that aim. So if you look here, we have a long list of immobilization devices which we're going to do our best to take you through all of them. Thank you very much, and then enjoy.
Yes. So just like Chris said, this is the easy glide, and it's probably the first thing we put on the couch. It's supposed to help us be able to move the patient. In order for us to move the patient, so we can drag this up and down to move our patient. And then what we have here is the wing board. We can use it either with the breast boring pumps we talk about or alone, usually for lung cases. This holds the help, that's the glide, and then
okay, so this is a setup for breast cases. We have the wing block, we have the inclination block, then we have the bottom stopper, and then we have the knee rest. Okay, so as you can see, as the name indicates, the bottom stopper and the knee rest is there just to support the pelvic or the lower region of the patient. This is made up of foam pads, so the patient feels some comfort when they are lying over here. So the bottom of the patient will be in this region, whilst the chest wall rests over here around this inclination board. It's made up of an angle of about 30 degrees, and that is to help the patient have an inclination of the chest wall. And then that inclination will give you the power surface. The chest wall to the couch, the treatment couch. Because as you know, the chest wall bodies out a bit. So as the patient lies on this inclination, it makes the chest wall parallel to the treatment couch. Now over here, we have a foam pad, and then we have another foam pad over here. This is for the patient to rest the elbow over here, then the wrist over here. This provides comfort for the patient again. Then this one stabilizes the hand. It takes away the hand from the treatment flow. As you also know, once the patient raises the hands and places them here, it elevates the chest wall a bit and raises the breast tissue superiorly. So that's how we have this combination over here. The wing board and then the inclination board over here.
It comprises of the knee rest and the foot rest. So the knee rest is usually used to support the knees of the patient, that's the lower legs. And the patient lays flat on the couch, and the place is uncomfortable. So in order to achieve maximum comfort and ability for the patient, we need to ensure that the patient doesn't move, we employ the knee rest. So as you can see here as well, we have varied alphabets. Okay, and this can be moved forward or backward depending on the length of the patient's leg. And also for the knee rest, the hole is quite wide to accommodate varying sizes of the legs. So this whole assembly is usually fixed to the couch with the use of a metal bar. So the bar is fixed to the couch, and then the foot assembly is fixed this way to ensure that the patient doesn't move during the treatment process.
I'm sure most of you have heard about the head mask and people talking about it. It's also an immobilization device which we use for head and neck setups. Basically, most of the time for head and neck cases, like nasopharyngeal cases, we try to use the 5-point mask, which would help us also to immobilize the shoulders as well as the head. For cases like cold brain or brain tumors, we use only the 3-point, which immobilizes just the head. Now, this is how it looks like from the beginning. It's like this. And then we don't use them alone. We use them in conjunction with the base plate, and then we also use the headrests. Now, the headrests come in as a result of the fact that the patient cannot lie just on the base plate. So you have to put in the headrest to make sure that the patient is really in a good position. Remember I told you about accuracy, I told you about comfortability, and then I also mentioned reproducibility. You want to maintain this throughout the whole treatment procedure. Now, with the headrest, we look at the patient, taking so many factors to decide what headrest to use for the patient. If you are choosing a case which demands a lot of head extension, then you use the headrest which is very, very down like this. This way you can be able to extend the neck very well, and then you can immobilize the patient. Also for cases where you don't need too much extension, maybe neutral head position, we use something like this. We use something like this which will help us with the positioning, and the patient's neck is okay, and we can reproduce it. It is accurate, and then it's also comfortable for the patient. When we do this, we put it in here like that, with the patient lying on the couch. The patient's head is going to be here, the legs are going to be there. Then after this, we set in with the mask. This is the 5-point, this is the 3-point. If we are concentrating on the mask, it's the same procedure. So we're going to put this in a water bath, which you see here. The water bath is open, it's heated to, we use 65 degrees Celsius, so it's heated to 65 degrees Celsius, then we put the mask in for a while. After a while, the mask becomes very soft, and then we can mold it on the face of the patient. After this, this is the end result. This is what we have for the mask, and this is what the patient goes through. So with this, the patient is not able to move the head sideways or up and down, and as such, we are able to get our radiation to the exact target that we are going to treat, thereby falling within our PTV and also having very small margins for the treatment. Okay, so this is how the patients feel when we put the mask on. Sometimes it can really be very uncomfortable, but
yeah!
Why we do them, and then what we use them for. So this is our little friend here, and then we're going to do the tattoos on him. This is how we're going to start. Patient is put on the couch, and then we actually put the patient in a good position which can be reproduced, and a very accurate one. So we do this, and then we are sure of how straight the patient is. As soon as we are okay with the position of the patient, then we go to fixed immovable parts on the patient's skin, where we can place the tattoos so that the tattoos are not movable and they stay in a particular position so that we can always use it for our setup every day for the treatment. So we use our skin markers. We make 3 tattoos on the patient, trying to use the lasers for the setup. So we do this and then that. On the anterior part, we do that for the lateral as well. And then we do the same on the other side. So with this, we are able to tell where the setup points are. And during planning, they see the setup points on the images, then they can use it for the plan. So this is the introduction of the tattoo. So imagine this position on the skin of the patient. So something like this. Now we are going to do the tattoo itself. The ink we use for the tattoo. You just put a little in here. That's it. And then we have specialized pins, which are not reusable, so use it once, and then that's it. So every patient uses one each. With this, we use it to take some of the tattoos. You can look, you can see there's a pin coming out as soon as I press. So we are going to put this on the machine. So we put it on like this. Then when you step on it, you can hear the sound. The needle comes out, and then we can do the tattoo. So we'll quickly have a tattoo session, then we can start.
Okay, so after we've marked our point of interest over here, as you can see, we then go and then we take a bit of the ink, indelible ink. Okay, so you can see there's a bit of the ink in the needle. Once we are ready, you put your pointer around the center of the intersection. And there we go. Then you'll be drilling through for about 30 seconds.
Okay.
So you can see that we have our indelible ink just under the skin. Okay. And then we clean the marks around.
The swab.
Okay, so you can see our ink remains there permanently.
It's a perfect tattoo.
Okay, so that's it.